Hello and welcome. The integral of 4x plus 3 divided by x squared plus 1 with respect to x, we explored that in our previous video, but let's do this another way and see if we can get the same result. And in this video, I'm going to find the integral by using a trigonometric substitution. Whenever we see this combination, x squared plus another number squared, let's say x squared plus a squared, which is what we have here. It's x squared plus 1 squared, and of course 1 squared is just equal to 1. Whenever we have this, we substitute x equals tan theta. And to understand why, I'll leave a link in the description box below to a previous video I did showing how this works. So here, if we let x equals tan theta, that implies then that dx to theta, so the differential with respect to theta, is going to be sec squared theta. So the expression for dx is equal to sec squared theta d theta. So my integral is going to become, I'll write it again, the integral of 4x plus 3 all over x squared plus 1 with respect to x is now equal to the integral of 4 times tan theta plus 3 all over tan squared theta plus 1 times sec squared theta to theta. And on the bottom, we know that this is equal to sec squared theta. So our integral shortens to 4 times tan theta plus 3 all over sec squared theta times sec squared theta d theta. And these sec squared theta are going to cancel out. So neatening up a bit more, we have 4 times the tan theta plus 3 d theta. And now I'm going to write this as two separate integrals, so that's going to be equal to 4 times the integral of tan theta d theta plus 3 times the integral of d theta. Alright, now the integral of tan theta we found out was equal to negative of the natural log of cos theta. And we have to multiply that by 4. The integral of d theta is just equal to theta, and that's now multiplied by 3. Let me write that a bit more neatly. So we found this integral in terms of theta, so we've got to transform it back into terms of x. And since x equals tan theta, this means that if I rearrange to get theta on its own, theta is equal to the inverse tan of x. Which I like to write as the arctan of x. So let me put this back in first. So I'm going to rewrite that as negative 4 ln of cos theta plus 3 times the arctan of x. Now for cos theta, to get that back into x is a little bit more tricky. If I construct myself a right angle triangle with the angle theta, because this is how I formulated the substitution, with the angle theta between the longer or the shorter sides and the hypotenuse, and we have our right angle here. If I call the opposite side x and I call the adjacent side 1, then by Pythagoras' theorem the length of the hypotenuse is x squared plus 1 square rooted, or I should say the square root of x squared plus 1. And from this, cos theta is equal to the adjacent side 1 over the hypotenuse, square root of x squared plus 1. So this now can be substituted for cos x. So continuing on, I would write 4, negative 4, times the natural log of 1 over the square root of x squared plus 1 plus 3 arctan x. Oh, I forgot to put a integration constant plus c here. So better make sure I do that for each integral that I do. This can also be written as, so I'll leave the negative 4 and the natural log. This can also be written as, according to my index laws, as square root, actually no, not the square root, but x squared plus 1 to the power of negative a half, and the rest of the expression remains unchanged. So that I don't have to keep rewriting the remainder part of the expression, I'm just going to work with this at the moment. The negative 4 can be rewritten as 2 times negative 2 of the natural log of x squared plus 1 to the power of negative a half. And using my log laws, I can rewrite that as 2 times the natural log of x squared plus 1 to the negative half times negative 2. So I'm just bringing this negative 2 up to the top, and that's now equal to 2 times the natural log of x squared plus 1. So to finish, I end up with 2 times the natural log of x squared plus 1 plus 3 times the arctan of x plus c. And that is exactly the same result as what I got in my last video. It took a little bit longer because we had a bit more manipulation to do, but as you can see, we get the same answer with two different approaches, which confirms that this is the correct result for this integral. If you have found this video useful, please give me a thumbs up. If you are currently studying math, please feel free to subscribe to my channel for future videos that may help you on exams or assignments. And as always, please feel free to ask me any question by commenting on any of the videos that you've seen. Thanks for watching, and I hope you've learned something.